Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaneyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilpandi. I am teaching the subject ME8693 Heat and Mass Transfer to the third year mechanical engineering students during this semester. I am going to share with you my experience on the active learning technique implemented in the classroom for solving the problem. The technique used is problem-based learning or PBL, and the details about the program, the problem-based learning too. So already I have conducted one activity on a particular topic, and this is the second activity of similar type. The subject code is ME8693 and the subject is heat and mass transfer in regulation 2017. So the class is 6th semester mechanical engineering A and C section. The topic is heat exchanger design. So solving problems on the heat exchanger. And the date is 19/2/2020. And the time is 10 a.m. to 12 noon, two periods. And the venue is seminar hall. And the details about the team. So A section, there are 45 students, 40 students were present on the day, 5 students were absent. The total number of teams are 14, so each team maximum of 2, and the last 2 teams are with the 2 students. And C section, 44 is the class strength, and the number of students present was 42, and the absent, there are 2 students absent on the day. Number of teams are 14, number of students per team is 3. And this is the second activity of similar type. So the team formation, the students are familiar. So as I told them to form a team, they formed the team on their own, 3 members. The like-minded people and their friends, they joined together and they occupied the seat. Then later on, I verified the team and adjusted the members in such a way that in every team, at least one average, above average, in every team, one above average student is available. Then the team behavior. So the behavior, the instructions were given to the students how to behave as a team, what is expected from them, and how to discuss and solve the problem. Then the general code of conduct inside the classroom, that was also instructed to the students. And this is the question paper for the activity. There are 5 problems in the question paper. They have to answer all the 5 problems. The maximum mark to the answer, maximum mark is 50. 10 marks each and the maximum mark equal to 50. And this is how the students are working in the seminar hall. So the students are sitting in groups of different batches. And these are all the another photograph of the team members. Then this is the statistical information about the examination. The maximum mark is 50, minimum mark to pass is 25, number of teams passed in the A section are 12, number of teams passed in the C section are 11, and the mark distribution is given here. First team A section 41, second team 37, third team 48, fourth team 44, 5th team 40, 6th team 27, 17, 8th team 48, 9th team 43, 10th team 39, 11th team 30, 12th team 47, 13th team 12, and 14th team 28. And C section, 1st team 42, 2nd team 44, 3rd team 31, 4th team 0. They have not responded. They have not completed the paper in time, all the 5 problems in time. And I told them to submit the paper in the afternoon after the tea break, after the lunch break. But they did not turn up, so I put them 0. 5th team 35, 6th team 30, 7th team 30, 8th team 27, 9th team 22, 10th team 31, 11th team 36, 12th team 25, 13th team 44, and the last team 20. And this is the another analysis of the statistical information. I classified A section, C section. Highest score is 44 in A section, C section it is 40, sorry, highest A section 48, C section 44. Lowest score in the A section is 12 and the C section is 0. Average score in the A section is 36 and in the C section is 30. But number of teams scored above average 9 in each class, number of teams scored below average 5 in each class. So in the C section, the data is less. So you look at here 4 marks less in the highest score, 0 mark, there is one team got 0 marks. And the average mark is also less by 6. So 36 in the A section and 30 in the C section. So the overall performance of the C section students are little poor. And this is the sample answer paper of a top performer in the A section with the 48 mark. A8 is the team. So the 48 mark out of 50 they scored. And this is the question paper. And after completing the answer, I told them to write feedback on the back side of the question paper. So the what they see, or what is their experience of the activity or problem solving technique, I told them to write the feedback. Their feedback, it goes like this: need more practice on the unit conversion. So they were poor in unit conversion, they want more practice on the unit conversion. Useful in revising the topic and got clarity in the procedure of how to solve the problem. And after distributing the paper, so after seeing their paper, I told them to write what are their mistake, so that they can rectify in future. So they identified two mistakes. One is wrong selection of method. So there are two methods for solving problem in the heat exchange design. One is LMTD method and the effectiveness NT method. So they wrongly selected a particular method, then reading error from the effectiveness value. So they, from the chart, they have to take data, read the information. So in the chart reading, they have done some mistake, small mistake in the effectiveness reading. And this is the answer sheet. Then the members are Harini Revati and Harshini. And in the first question, the answer is little lower because of their reading. NTU value, they have taken a lower value of NTU from the graph. So the answer is 234, whereas the exact answer is 239 meter square. And in the second problem, so they have calculated everything and the answer is exactly correct, 2.21 meter square area. Third problem, again they have done a mistake on taking the NTU value from the problem, but actually this problem would have been solved in the LMTD method. That is also another way. And the fourth problem, it is completely correct. The temperatures are correct exactly. And the fifth problem, again, the length of the heat exchanger is exactly correct, 103.3 meters. So they got 48. Then report. So actually, this is the second activity on problem solving. They know very well about the team formation, discussion, solving the problem. So once the instructions were given about the role and what is expected from them, they were calm and focusing on solving the problem. They were actively discussing and solving the problem. I went around and assisted them when they asked for a doubt. The number of teams scored below average is 10 against 15 in the previous activity. So previous activity solved the problem on the convection heat transfer. So there were 15 teams were scored less than the average, but now it is improved. Once they understand the power of, so they understood the power of peer learning, learning from their team members, so they are doing better. They have improved from the previous activity. A few students who are absent regularly in the class are combined to with the good students to learn from them. And as I told you, I told the student to write their feedback. So this is one sample of the feedback. This type of activity improves our team working skill. The student, they have written like this at the back side of their question paper. It helps us to improve our leadership quality. This activity helps us to share our knowledge with our team members. By solving the problem with a team, we can cross-check the values easily. By working as a team, we can reduce the time to solve the problem. So these are all the feedback from the student. And this is another feedback. Need more practice That is what I told. I was shown earlier. Need more practice on the unit conversion, useful in revising the topic, got clarity in the procedure, how to solve the problem. And I have consolidated the feedback from other answer papers. I have consolidated the, some of the repeated points are, this type of activity improve our team working skill. It helps us to improve leadership quality. This activity helps us to share our knowledge with our team members. By solving the problem with the team, we can cross-check the values easily. By working as a team, we can reduce the time to solve the problem. Useful for revising the topic. Got clarity in procedure how to solve the problem. It is helpful to slow learners to clarify their doubt. Easy to clarify their doubt. Group interaction improved while discussing. Presentation data is improved. Helps to remember the formula for the group member and easy for exam preparation. So these are all the feedbacks given by the student about their activity. At the end of the activity, they have to, after completing the problem solving, after solving all the five problems, they have written like this. And what are the mistakes by the student? So this also I instructed them after distributing the paper. So some mistake, one mistake I have shown earlier, wrong selection of method and reading error for effectiveness value. Another team they have written like this. The outlet temperature formula, they have written the correct formula here, whereas they have taken a wrong formula while calculating the value. And the mistake made for the graph value reading. So reading the value from the graph, they have made a mistake. So I actually, instead of we teachers informing them their mistake, if they identify their mistake, then easily it is easy for them to rectify. So that is why it is again psychological way of helping the student to identify their mistake. So instead of we inform them their mistake and shouting at them to correct, so if they identify, it will be easy for them to rectify their mistake. So that is the idea. So that is why I told them to write their mistake on distributing the paper. And thank you. So actually, if you have any comments on the presentation, you can pass it on. You can inform me through the video so that I can improve the activity in future. Thank you once again.